Good morning. Today we'll be continuing the same worksheet that I'm discussing in the previous session. So I have discussed the first problem regarding proving root 2 is irrational, and I have given you similar kind of problems as a homework. That is for root 3 and root 5. So the steps and all are similar to root 2, with exception to the change in number. So there, for 2 you have square of 2, whereas for 3 you have square of 3, and 5 you will have square of 5. Apart from that, there will be no changes in the argument or the steps which I have written. So now fourth one is a general case of what you have done in the first three problems. So let me discuss the fourth problem. And for any p, that is p is a prime number, you put any prime number in place of p, and the proof follows the same for all those numbers. For example, if you take p as 2, then that is the first question. If you take p as 3, that is the second one. If you take p as 5, that is your third question. Likewise, whatever the prime number is for p, then the question follows as per the prime number which you are taking. So this is the most general case which I am proving it. Okay. So as per the process, so we will be assuming that root p is a rational number, and we try to arrive at a contradiction. Same process. No difference at all. So let us assume root p is rational. So when root p is rational, you can write that root p in terms of p by q form, that is in terms of a by b. So that is what I am writing. That means that root p is equal to a by b, where b not equal to 0, a comma b belongs to integers, that is a comma b are integers, and HCF of a comma b is equal to 1. So this is a standard statement that you always take whenever you assume a rational number. So this is the case. Now cross multiply. So when you cross multiply, so this is b root p is equal to a. Now do the squaring on both sides. If you do squaring on both sides, now this is the case. B root p whole square is equal to a square. Now here our focus is on p. Okay, so that is what our focus is. So then this implies b square root p whole square is equal to a square. Now square and root, they get cancelled. So we are left over p b square is equal to a square. That is, now you have a square written as p into some integer. So whenever you are able to write a number as product of two integers, then we say that either of them divides the other as per the definition of divisibility. So here I can say that p divides a square. If p divides a square, I can conclude that p divides a. Again, by definition of divisibility, if any number divides the other number, there exists an integer. That is, a is equal to some, a is equal to pc for some integer c. Now do the squaring. So this is a square is equal to p square c square when you do a squaring on both sides. Now substitute in this equation. Let us say this is 1. Substitute in this by 1. Pb square is equal to p square c square. Now bring p to the other side. Then this is b square is equal to p square c square by p. Now this p and the square, they get cancelled. You are left over with p c square. Now b square is written as p into some integer. So then we can say that p divides b square as per the definition. So p divides b square. If p divides b square, as per the theorem which we have discussed on the previous day, you can say p divides b. Now if you look into this, p divides b, p divides a. But initially we have taken that a and b are divided by only one. There is no other number which divides a and b. But here we are arriving at a number, we are arriving at a prime number which is dividing both a and b. Since I mentioned that p is a prime number, p cannot be 1. That is, there is other number, there is a number other than 1 which divides a and b. So this is a contradiction to this statement, that is a and b are co-primes. Or in other words, there is no other number except 1 which divides a and b. So that statement is being contradicted by this, that is p is a common factor of a and b. So that contradiction has arisen because you have assumed root p is rational, therefore root p is irrational. So that is what I will write. Plus, what I'll write. Therefore, p is a common factor. P is a common factor of a and b. This is a contradiction. And therefore, you can say that p is irrational. General case, instead of using numericals, we have proved it for any prime number p. That is, p takes any prime number, this argument holds. That is, this proof holds for p as any prime number. So, that is it with regards to proving root p is an irrational number. Next. Fifth one. So we have to prove 3 root 2 is an irrational number. Now I will be doing 3 root 2 as irrational, and 6th question and 7th question are for your homework, which are similar to the 5th one. So look into that. So we have to prove 3 root 2 is an irrational number. So for that purpose, what I am doing is I will be assuming 3 root 2 as a rational number. Yes? 3 root 2 is rational. If 3 root 2 is rational, you can express 3 root 2 in the form of p by q. You can write that. So that implies 3 root 2 is equal to a by b, in brackets b not equal to 0, a and b are integers. You can also write HCF of a and b is 1. That makes no difference in this case. When you go along, you will be able to understand much better. Or if you want, you can write. HCF of a and b is 1. Now bring this 3 to this side, and that implies root 2 is equal to a by 3b. Now look into this. A is an integer, b is an integer, 3 is an integer. So product of two integers is an integer. So finally this is integer by integer. Integer by integer is a rational number. So root 2 is a rational number. This implies root 2 is a rational number, but we have proved that root 2 is irrational. Therefore, this is contradicting that statement. So that contradiction has arisen because we have assumed something incorrect. The incorrect assumption is root 2 is rational. Therefore, the correct thing is root 3 root 2 is irrational. I repeat it again. Root 2 is a rational number. That is what the conclusion that we can make here. But we have already proved that root 2 is irrational. But we have come across a conclusion that root 2 is rational. So these are both contradicting statements. So this contradiction has arisen because we have assumed something incorrect. The incorrect assumption is 3 root 2 is rational. Therefore, the correct thing is 3 root 2 is irrational. So that is what it is. This is a contradiction. So 3 root 2 is irrational. So that is the way to go about. So that is about this problem. So similar to this, you can do 6th and 7th on the same lines. There will be no difference. Or if you want to write much more clearly here, after this step, you can write here a by 3b is a rational number. After this statement, you can write here a by 3b is a rational number. That implies root 2 is a rational number. This is a contradiction. So root 3, so 3 root 2 is irrational. That is what you can write. Next one. So as I told you, 6th and 7th are homework. Even 8th one is homework. 8th problem is homework. I will be telling you 9th and 10th, so 8th one is similar to the 9th and 10th problems, so there will be no issue on that. So look into the 9th problem again, let's, or in fact what I do is I'll do 8th problem and 10th problem, take 9th problem as homework. That will be easier for you. So I'll go with 10th one first, then I revert back to the 8th one. So we have to prove that 3 by 2 root 5 is an irrational number. So let us assume that that is a rational. Let 3 by 2 root 5 is the rational number. So since it is a rational number, that can be expressed in the form of p by q, right? That implies 3 by 2 root 5 is equal to a by b, where b not equal to 0, a and b are integers, and we can also write HCF of a and b is equal to 1. That makes no difference. That is the reason I am not writing it. If I am using that, I would have written that. So that HCF of a and b indicates that these two cannot be further divided. For example, to, some 42 or say some 16 by 36. Suppose this is the case. 16 by 36 is a rational number. And if you cancel it, then this is 4, 4, 7, 4, 9, 7. So 4 by 9. Now there are no numbers or no common number which divides 4 and 9 exactly. So the only common factor over here is 1. So this is called the simplest form of 16 by 36. Here when I say HCF of A and B, it means that A by B is in its simplest form like this. That is the meaning of HCF of A and B is equal to 1. So now cross multiply this. When you cross multiply, this is the case. 2 root 5 into A is 2 root 5A. 3 into B is 3B. Now bring 2 to this side, A to this side, and what do you get? Root 5 is equal to 3B by, bring 2 to this side, A to this side. So here 3 is an integer, B is an integer. Product of two integers is an integer. Likewise, product of two integers is an integer. Now this is integer by integer. Integer by integer is a rational number. So from this you can conclude that root 5 is a rational number. But root 5 is irrational. We have already proved it. So root 5 is irrational. So this statement which we have got is contradicting that statement. That is, we have two statements. One is root 5 is irrational. Another one is root 5 is rational. Both of them are contradicting. So we have arrived at a contradiction because we have assumed something incorrect. The incorrect assumption is 3 by 2 root 5 is a rational number. So the correct assumption is 3 by 2 root 5 is irrational. So that is what I thought. This implies root 5 is rational. This is a contradiction. This is a contradiction. Therefore, 3 by 2 root 5 is irrational. Here you can write this. Here, root here, 3 by 2a is a rational number. So that implies root 5 is rational. So that is the way to go about. Now that is similar to the 9th problem. 9th problem is much easier. You just cross multiply and try to arrive at 7. 7 root 7 is an irrational number, but you will arrive at root 7 is rational. So that's it. Both of them are contradicting. So that is just, I'll go with that 1 by root 2. So again, same process. Let 1 by root 2 is rational. So 1 by root 2 is rational, therefore you can express 1 by root 2 in the form of a by b, where b not equal to 0, a and b are integers. Again, do a cross multiplication. Root 2 a is equal to b. Now we want root 2. Root 2 is equal to b by a. So this is a rational number. That is, root 2 is rational. So if root 2 is rational, this is contradicting the statement root 2 is irrational. Therefore, this contradiction has arisen because you have assumed something wrong. The wrong assumption is 1 by root 2 is rational. Therefore, 1 by root 2 should be irrational. That's it. So root 2 is rational. This is a contradiction. This is a contradiction. So 1 by root 2 is irrational. So that is it. So that is it about this worksheet. So whatever the problems that I have left over are for your homework, and these problems are rather easy for the day. And what you do is, along with these problems, I want you to learn a plus b whole square and a minus b whole square, so that in the next set of problems, so we will be coming across the usage of a plus b whole square and a minus b whole square in order to prove some numbers as iteration. So that is it all for the day. Thank you.